Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, in the name of Allah, the Most Beneficent, the Most Merciful. On Tuesday morning, we lost Jack, someone who has been around us for years. I have personally known him for 30 years. Jack is someone who went through hard times in life, but Jack was a gem of a guy. He really loved our community. He loved us so much, but we didn't show him love back. I will mention a few things that everyone can resonate with, and so the rest of the world can know who our Jack really was. Every time a car pulled up with an elder, Jack would run to open the door and help them cross the road. If it was raining, he would be standing there with his umbrella, giving them cover, yet often getting drenched himself. If it was a woman with kids, he would assist her to the front door. If it was a woman on her own, he would make her feel secure. He would stay to the end and clean the mess that we had left behind. And Jack would welcome every single person who came to Hadrian Mambarga with the most beautiful smile. Our kids at Madrasa loved him because he played with them. Our elders loved him because he respected them. And our youths loved him because he bonded with them. Jack had a way of relating to everyone. Yet sadly, in his own words, he once told me, "Bro, not everyone treats me nicely. Some people see me as a burden or an unequal." I saw the outpouring of love over the last couple of days from everyone I know, a real justification of what Jack meant to us. I know he would be in tears if he could see this, and in disbelief. In fact, he would be overwhelmed. I don't think he knew he was loved and valued so much. Why didn't he know? Because we didn't show it when he was around us. We had opportunities, but it was a burden giving him a lift at night, not thinking, so cold, how would he get home? Or having a chat with him, which he cherished so much. You know, Hadri and its people is all Jack had and all Jack knew. We were his family. Suddenly came a lockdown, and in this lockdown, life became impossible for the Jacks of this world. For they are forgotten about and left to suffer alone. It leads to depression and other mental illnesses. Just a phone call or FaceTime can make so much of a difference. Will we learn to show our love before people like our Jack are gone, or will we just be the same old people we are? There are a few individuals who did reach out to Jack, and he really appreciated it. He would say to me, "I spoke to so-and-so and so-and-so and so-and-so FaceTiming, these kids FaceTime me." And we do have some wonderful souls in our community. It would make him really happy. My point is this: so many more of us could have done so much more, but we didn't. Let us learn not to let those who love us feel unloved going forward. Let us learn to do something before it's too late. If you know anyone who's alone, call them. They need it most at a time like this. About Jack, some of you may have only known him recently over the last few years. When Jack was young, he was a very handsome and cool guy. Jack used to dress well, used to smell good, and he was just like any youth in our community. Unfortunately, life took a very bad turn with him. And at that time was when he needed some of his friends the most to help him. Unfortunately, a lot of us were not around. Going forward, if you know anyone who has problems, it is your duty as a Muslim and as a brother to help him and assist him get over that turmoil, for it can make a big difference to his life. In memory of Jack, on behalf of the elders of Hadri, the youth of Hadri, the sisters of Hadri, and the children of Hadri, rest in peace.